Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Do I have young people in this house? I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. Thank you, Brother Eddie. That was just amazing. Hallelujah. My name is Ngwasana Mpeta. I'm a minister right here at Jubilee Christian Center. And I've been honored to come and just share the word of the Lord for just a few minutes with you. Amen. Hallelujah. For just a few minutes, I will not take much of your time. Just want us to hear the word of the Lord and allow God to touch lives. Amen. Hallelujah. The entrance of the word of the Lord brings light. Wherever there is darkness, when the word is released, light comes. Hallelujah. Just allow me, even as I start, just to honor the servant of God, Bishop Mparutsa and Amai, who are the owners of this place where we are worshiping the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's just honor the servant of the Lord, Bishop and Mama Mparutsa. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Allow me to honor Reverend Machingura. He is right here. Reverend Machingura, we honor you, servant of the living God. He is the one that is in charge, the pastor in charge of the young adults group of this church. Glory be to Jesus. Allow me to honor Pastor Juma, amen, the servant of the living God that is seated right there at the back, who is wearing white like an angel. Hallelujah. We honor you, woman of God. I would also like to honor my best friend who is in this place, my wife, my beautiful wife. Glory be to Jesus. She is seated somewhere there in the back, a powerful woman of the Lord. Amen. Glory be to Jesus. Allow me to also honor the organizers of this thing. Thank you, Pastor Gam, Pastor Msomari there. She is the director of New Image, the Young Adults Group in this place, amen. And also in conjunction with TROAG, the Rise of a Chosen Generation, led by yours truly, Dr. Caleb, right there. Glory be to Jesus. Hallelujah. Also allow me to honor the leaders of Revived Hope Foundation, amen. It is genius, right? We honor you, genius. Amen. If you are still in the house, glory be to Jesus. And everyone else that has been doing ministry, may the good Lord bless you. We need such events in this season. As young people, we need such events. Hallelujah. I'm also a young person. I desire to fellowship with the Holy Spirit like what you are doing. Amen. That's why I am here. That's why I accepted this invitation. Amen. I also believe that this is a gathering of worshipers, is it? We are all worshipers, right? Yes. Worshipers are ministers. Natotanga kushia shukura mwari. Worshipers are ministers. Worshipers are ministers. Someone say worshipers are ministers. Glory be to Jesus. What it means is that we are not here to be entertained. We did not come here to be entertained. We came here to be ministered unto. Why? Because worshipers are ministers. If you came for entertainment, I'm very sorry, you came to the wrong place. And if you came to entertain someone, then I'm sorry, you are also in the wrong place. Because worshipers are ministers of the living God. When we gather as worshipers, we have gathered to minister unto the Lord, and we have gathered to minister to the body of Christ. That is the goal of this gathering, I would like to believe. We have gathered to arise in worship, and we have gathered to make God to arise in our midst. Israel, oh, I am in the wrong place. Glory be to Jesus. Now, you can't do effective ministry without the anointing of God. It is not possible. You can't effectively minister the Lord to his people if you have not encountered the Lord himself. If you have never encountered the heavens, then you cannot fully minister for the lives of people to be transformed. Every worshiper
must seek an encounter with the living God. And this afternoon, someone is going to encounter the Lord. I know that without any doubt, because he told me. Today, as we do ministry, as we worship, Vongai, the angels of the Lord who minister. You know, when Brother Eddie was ministering, I was seated by that corner. I was worshiping. I looked up and I looked at him. And I saw what looked like a mist right here. And I thought, my song, so I rubbed. And the mist was still. When you were kneeling there, I saw mist, white mist right there. Physically, not in the spirit, not in a vision. Physically, it was there. What am I saying? I'm saying today, your eyes are going to be opened for you to see the supernatural. The supernatural should be a daily thing in the life of a worshiper. I'm saying the supernatural should be something that is very common if you're a worshiper. Today, I want you to desire an encounter. Tashumiru atikanziko, revival is here. We are not waiting for revival, no. Because revival is here. By the grace of the Lord, he allowed me to write a book sometime this year. And the title of the book was Revival. We have never been this way before. Now, as I was sitting there worshiping the Lord said that you now know the way. You have now been there. You now know the way. Lead people to revival because you now know the way. One of the greatest ways to revival is worship. Genuine worship. Glory be to Jesus. Genuine worship. Glory be to Jesus. You know, basara worship is to nudge God so that he responds. If you stand in front of people to sing and God does not respond, it means you are missing something. If you are a worshiper and God does not respond, there is something that is missing. You must find out why. Why hasn't God responded when I worshipped? Because he says, draw close to me and I will draw close to you. When he is lifted up, he draws men unto himself. And that's what the word of the Lord says. So if God does not respond to his people when you worship, you need to spend more time with him. Today, I just want to minister for the next few minutes, probably 20 minutes, on a message that I've titled, God Responds. Tell your neighbor, God responds. God responds. And this is kutaura nyambo, ndikutaura zvinhu zvandiro ziva. These are not fairy tales. These are real things. When you nudge God, he responds. Now let us go into the word of the Lord. Time permitting, I'll read from Genesis 28, I'll read from Isaiah 63, and I'll also read from Revelation 4. Tinge tichingonzwa kuti mweya wacho ari kufamba sei ndizvo. I've been asked to be quite practical. Quite practical. I will not bore you much with theory, but I'll try to share things that have been tried and tested that work. Hallelujah. When you are doing ministry as worshippers, you want to go through a song list. No. Always be sensitive to the wind of the Holy Spirit. Always be sensitive to what he is doing. Maybe that day he just wants you to sing one song and people will be transformed. The moment you change the song, he goes. Even when you are doing ministry, when you are preaching, always be sensitive to the wind
of the Holy Spirit. Someone is getting healed as I speak right now. Some cancerous cells are dying right now. You shall testify. Is Dr. Caleb around? When he comes, please just be on the keys. Yeah. Baba Machingura will help me to do ministry very soon. He has a word that the Lord is dropping into his spirit right now as I speak. Hallelujah. Sorry to ambush you, but there's a word for these young people that the Lord is dropping. There's one thing that the Lord was teaching me a few weeks back, that Adonai himself, God himself, Yahweh himself, El Shaddai himself, desires to respond to his children, but his children are not seeking his attention, so he can't respond. There are certain things that a human being can do to make God to respond. There are certain things, or given a few things, but I won't share all of them. There are a couple of things that if you do, God responds. Number one, humility. If you're a humble person, God will respond. Because God resists the proud. So if you are proud and you come here and open the mic, you will not respond. Then the man of God, Prophet John, the one that we call the Baptist, he says, I decrease so that you increase. When he did that, God appeared. Hallelujah. He baptized God. A man baptized God. Why? Because he decreased to allow God to increase. And he was given an honor that no other man has been given, to baptize God. When you baptize God, the heavens were opened. It's the first time in centuries and thousands of years that we saw the Holy Ghost appearing back on the scene, and he came down in the form of a dove. Why? Because a man had decided to be humble so that God responds. Unga one voice rako rakanaka. Rekuti ukataura soka. Yeah, tinozva kuti pataura. Asi kana usiri humble, sing as much as you want. Tinoda tonza pati dry. You will not come down. No miracles happen. No one will be delivered. Number two, God responds to a sacrifice. If you go throughout the Bible, right from the start in the book of Genesis to the last book of the Bible, Revelations, there were people that were sacrificing and God comes. They put a sacrifice. God responded to one sacrifice and he rejected another. God responds to sacrifice. What is it that you are sacrificing in the house of the Lord, in the kingdom of God? Do you know organizing this thing is not easy? It is expensive, it's tiring. It is a sacrifice. They came on a Dr. Caleb, Vachi practice. They were sacrificing their time, their fuel, their everything. When God starts responding to them, was I jealous? Because God responds to a sacrifice. What is it that you are sacrificing? In the whole of this event, and you wonder why God is not responding to you. One thing that I've practiced in my life for a very long time and I've seen working, God responds to confidence. If you're confident in your God, he sees it and he responds. God is going to heal the sick. But just because I stood and I said that I believe that my God heals the sick, so today he shall heal the sick. I've seen the sick being healed. I've seen miracles. Just because I've been confident in the God that I serve. I've seen the dumb speak. Why? Because a man has just been confident in their God and says, you shall speak. Don't laugh. You, Paori Papa, got 2 months ago. Just because you are confident in your God, you can stand up and declare and say, God is going to transform your life and lives are transformed. Because he responds to confidence. Be confident in your God. Be confident and he comes down. Like I said, lives are going to be transformed today. There are going to be encounters. Today, there are five people. You are going to have encounters in your dreams when you sleep. You are going to have wonderful dreams that have to do with your destiny. Let me just skip that. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Someone just stand up for a few minutes. Just stand up. All of us, stand up. Worship is the substance of the supernatural. Worship is the substance of the supernatural. Without worship, it is difficult to access the supernatural. I repeat, without worship, it is difficult to access the supernatural. Because worship is the substance of the supernatural. You cannot expect to move in the supernatural if you are too lazy to pray. Hear me? Hear me clearly? Let this sink into your head. You cannot expect to move in the supernatural if you are too lazy to pray. It's not possible. I don't mean to brag, but I'm just trying to be practical. You can ask my wife today, I woke up at 2 a.m. praying for you, praying for this event. Because I know that you cannot move in the supernatural if you are too lazy to pray. It's not possible. It's not possible. It's not possible. You want to move in the supernatural when you pray for 2 minutes a day. You are joking. You are joking. I'm telling you, you are joking. Musanyepere. Akuna theology rakadayo. They lie to you that kwanzi it is quality. God desires quality. They are lying to you. God desires both quality and quantity. Quality. I've watched it. It's quality time. He does not come down. He desires both. My brother, come here. You, I see the desire for prayer. You are an intercessor. Are you? What are you? See a lot of prayer in you. And God is saying that he is igniting a fire in your spirit today. There's a fire. You have been called to pray and things happen. The foundations of Zimbabwe shall hear your voice, young man. Don't be afraid of them because you have been anointed. Ziabanga jigalada. I'm telling you, believe me, we shall see visions of things that are scary that control this nation. You are protected. Pray. Lazinda gajidaba karidade boza. No tricks will bring the supernatural down. No acting will bring God down. Skill does not bring God down. We are not skilled to manifest God. No, there's nothing like that in the Bible. We seek him and he responds. Akuna skill ekubulisa mwari musanyeperwe. Ask the ancients, they will tell you that they will seek God day and night and you will come down. When Moses has no skill, they go for a Red Sea. Quete. It's because of the God that anointed them, that they will spend time with, that they will open the Red Sea. That Joshua will part the River Jordan. It's not a skill. It's not vocal prowess.
Deborah, it was not vocal prowess that made her to be a prophetess. No.
It was the presence of God. She spent time in the presence of God.
I say that you cannot access the supernatural if you are too lazy to pray.
You know, those are the voice language around Bonaka Pariza. I said, no, Bruce Amari. All of you have better voices than me. But what have you done with your better voices? Have you brought down God?
Today, He wants to use you. I'm saying today, He wants to use you. Today, He wants to use you.
As this is very special for you, my sister. The lame can walk, the blind can see through you. It's not about height. It's not about stature. It's about your relationship with Him.
He is in this place, Shabarida.
There was a lady that was dancing here who was wearing, was it red or maroon or what? Is she still here? May she come to the front? Yes, please come, Dajida Bahaya. You don't know what you're doing, my sister. Angels were dancing with you and you didn't see. Angels were dancing with you and you didn't see. Whatever it is that is happening in your life, God is saying that I'm coming.
There's a shift in your life. Zida Bahaya.
God is talking to me right now as we speak about Jacob. And I want to preach about Jacob actually. And his life was never the same. That's what God is saying. That is what I want to do in your life.
Thank you for a shift.
Many shall come to the knowledge of Christ through you without putting much effort. Without putting much effort. Lift up your hands. Father, I thank you for your grace upon my sister. Thank you for the fire of the Holy Ghost. I trust and believe that you have spoken to her. The way that she was dancing, she didn't know, but she was interacting with the supernatural. And your angels came down and danced with her. I thank you that you are putting into order everything back home. Right now, you are putting into order everything that is in disorder at home because of her dance. I thank you. I see that disorder. And I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. And she has already started rebuking it by her dance. I thank you. When she goes home, they are going to see that there's something different. They won't be able to put a finger on it, but they will know that something has happened into her life. Here, Zida Baha. Thank you. He is doing something. Why I've asked you to stand, I want you to pray with me for a couple, 60 seconds. If you can speak in tongues, I want you to speak in tongues. If you can't speak in tongues, I want you to worship. And I believe by the end of this day, you'll go home speaking in tongues. Let us pray. Ndazi dagaba kashete kabura baza kila ndangande gede ribashe kepozo kupaha rakabashe kende lekebosa rikeposha kanda gade rala tandenge ndenge ndegebosa. Somebody pray shikabaha. Somebody push in the spirit. Jila bosa barikala kateke bosa rakabaha rekebahanga la kabasheke baha rikemoso kobaha shandanda la kabade ndiaza endiaza ngandinga mosoto baha rala kabasheke baha. You can take your seats. I'm almost done. There is a principle that I call the principle of spending time in your presence. The principle of spending time in your presence. Listen to me and listen to me clearly. If you go to a filling station fuel filling station, and you sit there for an hour. There are some angels that has just come in this place. Hallelujah. If you spend an hour, ukavai papo, usna mbobala petrol, but you were just in a filling station. After an hour, ukava, your clothes will be smelling of fuel. Try it. Go and spend, just sit by filling station for an hour. After you leave, your clothes will be smelling of petrol. Why? Because you have spent time at a filling station, something rubs off. Ukanda kuparrenyatwa. Ka spend some time uri mparrenyatwa. For a few minutes after wava, unongo chirungonzwa kunwa kwemushonga, isn't it? Auna mushonga wabata. Is spending time in a presence. Something rubs off on you. Because you have spent time in a presence. Every environment releases something if you spend considerable time in it. Every environment, whether it is physical or it is spiritual, every environment releases something onto you. I believe areas where nuclear waste was released or chemical toxins were released. Amen. Is it Chernobyl? What is it? What do they call it? Ah, it's okay. When those toxins were released, people did not detect them getting into their bodies, into their systems. But after years, some people started giving birth to disabled children. It is because in such a year, toxins were released into an environment. Some people died. Some people got seriously sick. And some people gave birth to disabled children. So sometimes, I always feel like something has come into my body when you spend time in a presence. But something always rubs off. But today we're talking about the presence of God. If you spend time in the presence of God, the glory of the Lord rubs off on you. Ask the man of God, Moses. He went up the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. Hallelujah. And his face shone with the glory of the Lord. With the glory of the Lord. I always give an example of a friend of mine. Friend of mine. He's about 2 years older than me. That man prayed. He would leave home before 8. And he go up the mountains of Kwekwe. And he would pray. Some people thought that he was employed. But for a year he was like that. Then there's this evening when people went to pray with him. In the middle of the night. And they were tired and they wanted to go home. They called him. When he turned, his face was white as snow. And they were all slain in the spirit. This is a man that I know, a good friend of mine. The same experiences are still happening. The same encounters are still happening. But we only get them if we spend time in the presence of God. Religious. I started reading a Bible. Genesis 28. From verse 10. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. And he came to a certain place and stayed there that night. He stayed there that night. Whenever the Bible speaks about night, it is speaking about hardship. It's speaking about calamity. And when the Bible talks about night, it is saying that there is a breakthrough that is coming, which is called dawn or day. Hallelujah.
You can cry all night, but joy comes in the morning. So whenever we see night in the Bible, especially in the Old Testament, it's speaking about calamity or hardship that comes just before a breakthrough. And the English say that the darkest hour is before. So the man of God, Jacob, stayed the night in that place, taking one of the stones of the place, and he put it under his head and laid down to sleep. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and laid down to sleep. If you go to Luke 19 verse 40, it will tell you what stones usually represent. They represent praise. Because Jesus said to them, if these guys, if these people stay silent, even the stones will cry out to me in praise. So the man of God, Jacob, took praise and used it as a pillow. Verse number 12. And he dreamed, and behold, there was a ladder set up on the earth, and the top reached heaven. And behold, angels or messengers of God were ascending and descending on it. They were ascending and descending. Like what is happening right now is, I minister, they are here, they are not going to come down, they are already here. You understand? Ladder could either represent Jesus, because he is the way to the Father. So the ladder was reaching to the Father. Or the ladder could represent prayer. Because for you to access the supernatural, you need to climb the ladder of prayer. Prayer in ladder, in number steps. That's why I said, if you're too lazy to pray, you will not experience the supernatural. You can pray for provision. You want chingwa mangwana chikawe chingwa. Ladder number one, step number one. But if you're too lazy, ushangona matra chingwa and uchijika uchiguta. But you'll never get the deeper things of God. There's something about you. Yes, I'll tell you. Verse number 13. And behold, the Lord stood above it, above the ladder. I did a bit of research on that scripture. My theology is actually debatera. The original Hebrew text, it and God stood above it. It says, and God stood beside him. Vakato zika ladder, vakawe wakamira pa side nae. But because I'm not a theologian, I will not labor on that. And he said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. What is very interesting, he says, I am the Lord, the God of your father, Abraham. But that was his grandfather. On his real father, over Angotiko and Isaac. There's something deep right there. Time permitting, I will explain it. Verse 16, then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. This is none other than the house of God, or Bethel. This is the gate of heaven. Years before, his father Abraham had erected many altars as a way of sacrifice. God was responding to the sacrifices of his father. And Jacob met with God. What really happened? God responds to his mission and his will. That's why I'm not going to marry Chaga, because God has a plan with this person. Because God had a plan to bless and to transform the world through Abraham. So he was looking for someone
with the DNA of Abraham to bless the world. Because Jesus came through that bloodline. You understand? Now, Isu ne kukaranga tengisa birthright. So he was no longer a candidate. Panga pango sala Jacob. Because God responds to his mission, he came down and transformed the life of Jacob. If it is the Lord's will to use Troag, Revived Hope and New Image, because it is the mission of God, and you'll be blessed. I know you come from different churches. When the church says it's not mission, you won't be blessed. Ling around where God wants to use, and you'll be blessed. A little bit of research will tell you that word gate is the Hebrew word shah, which means an opening, an entrance, or a portal. He encountered the doorway to heaven. He encountered the doorway to heaven. May someone encounter a doorway to heaven today. Revelation chapter number 4, because of time. Chapter number 4, I will not read Isaiah 63 because of time. Revelation chapter number 4, verse 1. After this I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, come up here, and I will show you what must take place. John Alipa Island, the Patmos, Angarimuna, Ango, Angango Sara Nungon Namatamari. That was his job. Spending time in the presence of God. If you spend time in the presence of God, the heavens are opened. Prophet Isaiah Chivache Majibati, why don't you render the heavens and come down? A doorway, Seleka Africa Mna Genesis, was opened again in the book of Revelation, chapter number 4. And God spoke to men. That same word door, in Greek it is thura, which also means a portal, an entrance, a gate. It is a way into the supernatural. It is a way into the supernatural. And at once I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne in heaven with one seated on the throne. In Genesis, the man of God, Jacob, did not manage to get into the heavens, but he peeped and saw a glimpse of heaven. But John the Revelator managed to get into the heavens. Ama levels. Because Jesus had come and opened the way. Jesus had come and you and me, we are privileged. Tasiana Jacob. Because Jesus came and he opened the way to the Father. We are able to dine with him in the heavens. Do you want heaven and earth on your finances? Seek the Lord and the doors will be opened. Hallelujah. Do you want healing? Seek the Lord and the door of healing will be opened. Let me try to conclude. But what do we gain in spending time in the presence of God? What is it that we gain? What is it that we gain? What is it that we gain? Don't want to spend time in the presence of God. What is it that we really gain? Number one, if you spend time in the presence of God, you are protected. I've heard of them. They don't have protection. You gain protection. Some years back, ndakaona basa inshanda kune imwe nzvimbo yanga ine serious demonic activity. Before I went this other weekend, I dreamt and the Lord showed me someone wanting to kill me. You understand? I woke up, prayed about it, was not afraid because I knew my God had exposed the plan. So I went there. Mimbaibasa yanganda apiwa yoyo. On the second day, I found a huge snake, 1 meter. Huge snake. Pasnapa unoneka kutia iku nasa kupinda napo. But because I had been warned prior, I killed the snake. You understand? Where am I getting to? I was protected. But something more amazing happened. So that evening as I was praying, and I was thanking God for protection, He said that He will protect me even more. So I saw this gentleman who just walked into my room from the supernatural. It was not a man. My door was locked. And this man just stood. He was carrying weapons. And he just stood by my bed. And I slept like a baby. And he came every night for 3 months. Every single night. I'm not talking about visions. Whenever I would pray before going to sleep, he would just appear and stay the guard the whole night for 3 months. Something that happened is not a fairy tale. It's not everyone that is privileged to see, right? Like I said, I saw an angel dancing with my dear sister here. You might not see them, but if you spend time in His presence, you are protected wherever you go. I can tell you of countless stories that I've seen the protection of the Lord. I'm just trying to inspire someone here that it is possible. Azizema apostola, azizema profita, any child of God that spends time with God. I know of one person on Dakatente Utsa a couple of months ago. Akawe achifara achipa testimony kutiko kwakaka kuchida kunaya, and I commanded the rain to stop and it stopped immediately. A few months in the Lord. You only 15 years. What is a bete? I withdraw that. I think my name is Mandabaya. I withdraw that. It was not intended for you. Forgive me. Rila shikaba zida andagebosa. If you spend time in the presence of God, He will provide for you. Ask Obed Edom. This guy, the ark of the Lord, which represented the presence of the Lord, was carried into his house. And there was so much provision. There was never lack in his house. Why? Because he spent time in the presence of God. Why don't you make your house a door to heaven? Why don't you make your house a gate to heaven? Before COVID ravaged, me and my wife would open the house for sales. We would open the house for sales. So people would come. I think it was every Tuesday. People would come. Then I didn't even know. I had no clue. Do you know, whenever we are about kushika paduze nekumba kwenyu, probably about 400 meters away, we start sensing the presence of God. But it's very possible if you just direct someone, a home house number, you just tell them, Mutiko, walk this road. When you start sensing the presence of God, the house is to your left. I didn't know until they told me. I didn't know. I had no clue. They told me that it is a testimony.
who would know where you live by sensing the presence of God.
I don't know. We have to do sales.
Your car can be a doorway to heaven. Your house, your bedroom can be a doorway to heaven. I once read about the man of God, Benny Hinn, that he spent time in the presence of God. And she was hit by the power of God. His bedroom had become a doorway, a gate to heaven. You can change your bedroom to be a doorway to heaven by spending time in His presence. There are cars like that. Just get in there and you just start sensing the presence of God. But my house is still like that. As often about 2 years ago, someone came to my house and they said, I feel like praying. They just sat on the couch and said, I feel like praying. But on that day, I didn't feel like praying. Me and my wife wanted to watch a movie. So I told him, Shangwari, now I want to watch a movie. Go into the spare room and go and pray. I should have prayed. So he's still there. Yes, he's still there. Zoleka, you can turn it into the gate of heaven. That people will come from afar and their lives will be transformed. The apostle Peter, he himself hosted heaven. That even handkerchiefs would heal the sick. Even his shadow, Shaba, Barida, Beazita, Basheke Baha, could heal the sick. Worshippers, your voice can heal the sick. Your voice.
If someone gets healed, a man has been Omicron, I can't go and contaminate people, but I can do your way for a man. You are no emotion, Dada. No! God wants to use you, to use your voice to bring healing.
Presence.
Thank you.